Hi, Tom DeCan here with another Django video tutorial. In this one, I'm going to be showing you how to create ChatGPT with HTMX and Django very quickly, maybe what I want, aiming for 4 minutes. We'll be calling the OpenAI API, and we'll be using the exact model that ChatGPT uses. So after you've done this, you'll be able to add AI to any of your products. Let's get into it. We're here. I'll link the guide that this follows along. First of all, I've run this core here. I've already created that. I'm assuming you've got Django installed and have set up a virtual environment. Create our chatbot app, and then we need to install requests as well, which is a library that we will use, and is very nice. I've already got it because I've done this before. Okay, now installed apps, we'll add our chatbot app or whatever you're calling it to our settings in core settings. Now we're going to add our models, and this is going to be so we can save our conversation with ChatGPT to our database. So we add this in, paste it in here, and there's some slight off formatting, not quite right, so let's format that correctly. You could change this to a conversation, that's probably a nicer table name, but we'll leave that there for the moment. And now we'll copy and run our make our migrations. And then we just made our migrations, so created our database, and you'll see the little database pop up somewhere around here. There it is, SQLite. And now we're going to add our initial views and copy in here to control the data flow. We'll, as you can see, I'll explain this a little bit in a bit, but we've just got this sample bot message. Now let's create our front end. I go to our chatbot app and create a templates folder. This will hold our HTML, so templates, and then we'll create a HTML file in there called chat HTML. Irrelevant. And then we'll copy in this stuff here, which I've written there. And then we'll connect the remaining Django elements. Copy that and then go to the chatbot URLs, and here, create a URLs file. This is separate to the core URLs, so it's the layer below. Copy them in, and then we'll update our core URLs here with that. And now you can run python manage.py run server. I've already got that set up in this button. And then we go to here, and there we are. And so you'll probably see this screen first, and then go to chat, and here we are. And if we type something, let's type in what's some rational thing to say? I'm a fish, and the bot says hello. Perfect. So yeah, that's very nice. And so that's using our dummy line there, so it works, which is good. Let's add some AI. And so we need to go back to our views, and we're going to replace the previous stuff with this new code. And so you can see this is the same as before, except instead of it here where it said hello, we're going to get the AI response, which is here, which calls the OpenAI API. And then we also format it by getting all the messages that we've saved to the database before to load in the context for the conversation. Let's add our OpenAI API key. So as you can see, I've written just your API key code here. This is my... I've logged in, that's the URL I've used, maybe it's changed by now. But anyway, you need to just go in here, create a new secret key, this, call it no name needed, and then copy it in. This you should keep private, put this, insert that key in, make sure you have bearer at the front, that is necessary. And now let's close that, and now go back, reload, refresh. We've still got our previous conversation, maybe it would be a good idea to have a way of removing that, but we'll keep it for the moment. Now let's ask a question. What's the capital of Georgia? And there you go, there's the answer. And that's the, and we can ask it whatever we want. And you can see if we go down here, this is what we're printing here. And just to walk you through, leave me there for the moment. But we'll walk you through what's happening here. We visit the site chat, and that takes us here to our chatbot URLs, which we then go to just the chat view, which is here. Then it returns the template, which is here. And then, but then we use, when the user enters something, let's write something else. What is a fun thing to do with a hammer? As we type, we press that, then that sends a post request to using HTMX, which is here. So it's all asynchronous, and that sends it to the chat view. So it gets this data here that we're sending, it sends it to the chat view, which is here. It notices that it's a post, it gets our particular message, then it sends that message to our AI response, which is here. So that sends this, and then sends that with all, gets all of our previous messages here from our database, packages them up here into the way that OpenAI likes them, puts those in there, together with our user input, which is there. So we get an input. Our user input says we want to use GPT 3.5, which is the current the free version of ChatGPT. Provides that particular temperature. You can change that to do mainly with novelty, and then posts it, gets the response, returns that data to here, bot response, puts it into our database, then gets all the messages, puts them in context, sends them to this template. That template then comes back here. It renders the target here to this container, swaps only the HTML that's received there, and then re-renders. That's how to do it. That's it. So as you can see, we're all done. Excluding my explanation, it's a very fast thing to do. Hope you enjoyed that. If you want to know how to build Django really quickly, check out my product, photondesigner.com, which is a way to build Django entirely visually. And yeah, I hope you found that really useful.